Hello friends, in this video we will talk about Vaborbactam, Avibactam and Relebactam. They are all newer generation beta lactamase inhibitor and they are different from the older generation in the sense that the older beta lactamase inhibitors like Sulbactam, Tazobactam and Clovalonate were structurally similar to a beta lactam ring, and so the beta lactamases would target them, spare the antibiotic and allow the antibiotic to work. But gradually we found that the bacteria developed resistance, they overcame this beta lactamase inhibitors, and since 2015 we have this newer generation beta lactamase inhibitors available. The first was Avibactam, 2 years later it was Vaborbactam, and since 2019 the most recent one is Relebactam. Avibactam and Relebactam are more similar to each other in structure from a class of drugs called Dabcos, and Vaborbactam is a boronic acid derivative. And the major difference in the mechanism is that they bind to the beta lactamases covalently, and this is a reversible binding. With the older generation beta lactamase inhibitors, there was suicidal inhibition. So once they bound the enzyme, they inactivated the enzyme, but they themselves also got inactivated. But here, this is reversible. It is not known whether this particular mechanism actually makes them more effective. What we know is that they have extended the spectrum of the antibiotic. So the antibiotic when combined with them are able to cover more organisms, and this include across classes except for the MBLs, which are still resistant to all beta lactamase inhibitors. So we have ESBLs from class A, the KPCs from class A, the OXA from class D, and AMC, majority of them are carbapenem sensitive, but still this BLI combination will also give you activity against them. So we have an extended spectrum of antibiotic coverage, and among them as well the difference is there among the different serine classes against which they work. We need to recall that there is no activity against MBLs, including the NDM, IMP and VIM. Let's talk about the individual agents. Avibactam, the first available with combination ceftazidime since 2015, Vaborbactam with meropenem and Relebactam with imipenem cilastatin. They are the agents of choice when it comes to carbapenemase, especially the Enterobacter ashi, and of the serine type, which is class A, C and D. CAS-AV has activity against KPC, and they also have activity against OXA48, which meropenem Vaborbactam doesn't have. It is active only against the KPCs, among the most remarkable ones. And CAS-AV and Aztreonam has the greatest literature for coverage of MBLs. Although ceftazidime Avibactam itself is not active against MBLs, but because majority of the MBLs also carry certain form of serine proteases, the combination takes care of the different class of the beta lactamases, and this is almost the standard, the one which has the probably the largest literature for activity against the different classes of beta lactamase inhibitors, including for MBLs the combination of ceftazidime Avibactam and Aztreonam. All the three are recommended to treat difficult to treat Pseudomonas. This is as per the IDSA guidelines. And carbapenemases, which are elaborated by the enterobacterials, of which Enterobacter ashi is one. We need to know that they don't have activity against Acinetobacter. So neither the primary drug nor the newer generation BLI when combined gives you any edge over drug resistant Acinetobacter. They may be used in combination with other agents active against Acinetobacter, but as monotherapy they are not recommended. So what we have is a new generation of beta lactamase inhibitors which gives us extended spectrum, but we need to understand that the literature for them, especially with Relebactam, is very new. So it is only time which will tell us how much the activity is retained against the drug resistant bugs.